I need a gunshot. I need another gunshot. After shooting gun, let's pray. Sky Daddy, forgive me for I have sinned. It has been 116 days since the last pod.
Has it?
It's been 116 days.
Since, how many seconds?
Forgive our
I don't God. Know how many seconds, but
for
it's
real?
Fine.
Why?
There's some people. Cool. There's some people you should ask.
That would cool be like 115 days, 23 hours, and like 60 minutes.
Shasha, yeah. You're helping me break my podcast hiatus.
This is what we do.
Give me another Stop, gunshot. Baby, we different now. We different now.
Stop, baby. Take me out of dinner.
Do you know I'm even trying to buy time? Do you know I forgot my intro? Like, that's how long it has been.
It's cool.
Baby, what's good? What's
Hey, yo.
Facts.
That's a new one. Hey, yo.
Hey, yo. That hey, yo is not coming out right. I know they heard that really hard. Anyway, if you can hear my voice, I'm going to assume that you know what the heck is going on. But there might be some people that don't know what's going on. If you can hear my voice, you're listening to the voice of Jess, also known as Jess Finesse. And we are on season 2, episode 1 of Jess Finesse.
Episode 1. That's Jess. My new tag, by the way.
Are you serious? If I don't hear it on your song,
check the new article. This song is on there.
Shameless plug. Shameless plug. We are here again. It's been a long time coming, but it's better late than never.
Let's get it.
And late is better. We have a very special guest. This person is very special. Let me not cast that, but we have a special guest in the building.
What's up, baby?
Can you intro yourself?
You know, the host for the monster.
Yikes. How are you going to fumble like that?
Nah, that was intentional.
Oh, yeah.
That's the guy, man. Come on, baby.
You have started. No, be for real.
TMXO, in case you don't know.
Thank you. Good morning, your neighbor. How are you doing? Are you doing okay?
Sister Jessica, fine girl from America.
Oh, it's the memories for me.
I'll dream you first.
Bruh, I'm pretty sure I had to be through SARS.
Nah, way before that.
Are you serious?
Yes, no.
I don't remember.
Remember the song? I can't even sing the song again. But
why not?
You made the song happen now. Caesar Millie, Bad Girl. Myself featuring Caesar. You don't remember?
Yeah, so doing, you remember when I was a young tenderoni?
Yeah, I met you as a fresh IJGB.
Yes, my skin was still, you know, still
fresh supple. From the DMV. What's up, baby?
But yeah, me and TMXO go way back. So I think it's very full circle that you're the first guest on my podcast for season 2.
Episode 1.
We're here with different energy. It's real different. Thank you for, you know, pulling up.
I got you.
Because I know you're a busy man.
Exactly. I'm not busy doing anything.
It's not every day like you're sitting next to someone that like has been nominated for a Grammy. Like,
there are many people.
No, it's not by that. Like, don't come and downplay that.
What's up, baby?
You move different now, huh?
I like to think so. Yes.
You look, there's an air about you that's different. When I first met you, it was like, oh, it was a little bit like struggle, hustle. Now it's just like,
it's chilling.
We can't struggle for life, baby.
I think we're in very different spaces now. I know you're in different space, like in all aspects.
Yeah,
I feel like you're in a different space. Me, I think I'm still trying to reach that space.
No, but I mean,
I'm still looking for my daily 2K.
I can say that you're not in the same place I met you. So
I'm local now. I can't find my American passport.
We are doing better. You look good. You look healthy, fit.
Did I look sick when you met me?
Not that you look sick, but I'm just thanking God for
Lagos
your life.
Hasn't killed me.
Exactly.
Give me a gunshot.
That's what I'm saying.
Thank you. So, Jess Finesse Presents. You know the vibes, but in case you don't know, I invite people who are very interesting, who are, well, I say special to me. Everyone is special in their own very special way. So everyone is special.
Ojoro.
It's not Ojoro. It's for real. No, it's not. Everybody is special for real. But don't do that. And we talk about different topics over a very important meal. A meal that you can't just do with anybody. A ritual that you can't just do with anybody. And that is smoking Garri.
I'm with it.
Thank you.
I'm with everything.
So you're not too big to drink Garri.
It's my favorite. One of my favorites, actually.
Ojoro.
Nah, for real.
Very simple question.
Mm-hmm.
Very important answer. This answer can change a lot.
Let's get it.
It can change our relationship. It can change our interpersonal relationship. It can change how I view you. It can make me reduce respect for you. I don't know.
I don't mind. Suffice the truth.
Okay. One question. White or yellow?
White now. Jebu Garri now. With the schmack.
I don't know why I even asked you, because I feel like I would have gave us
with the schmack. But this is for
why are you giving siren?
For the white Garri.
Yes, so the not so the white Garri. Garri get?
Nothing.
Ooh.
But is that your favorite?
I don't drink that. This for real? This is all I drink.
That's for soup now, making eba.
Y'all say that. I've heard so many different claims. This thing tastes 50 times better than that.
It's got a schmack.
You say smack?
The schmack, yeah.
Why do you want your food to smack in your mouth?
It's going to smack you, yeah.
I like soft life. I don't like struggle.
To my calm, I feel
it. We already struggle every day. I don't want to struggle with my food.
It's just as a zest type thing. It's perfect. But I mean, hey, man. Choices.
Now.
Bow.
What do you take as what do you supplement your that atrocity that you put in your mouth that is white like that? What do you supplement it with?
I'm a very, you know, finesse eater.
Ooh. Just like my name.
Finesse.
TMXO, what do you put in your Garri?
But coconut. Ooh, not what? Coconut.
Did you say coconut?
I said coconut, yeah.
Okay.
But not. If you give me cough, just choke.
I've heard coconut before.
Ice, ekpa, groundnuts.
Is that what groundnut is in Yoruba?
Yes, no.
Ekpa.
Ekpa. Not
ekpa. Ekpa.
I don't know.
What's the difference?
Ekpa.
Ekpa. It's not.
Ekpa.
Not the way you're saying it. Ekpa. But yeah, ekpa.
Kill me. Okay.
Yeah.
Ekpa.
Ice, ekpa, sugar.
Okay.
I saw someone squeeze like lime or lemon into Garri recently.
That person's bougie.
I want to try it actually. Maybe when I get to my van, try it.
Like, is it comparable to like when someone is like, when you go to a restaurant and they're like, oh, do you want lemon in your water?
You're not, I don't know, child, but you're going to like have one. There's one feng shui that's going to, you know what I mean?
Have you tried salt and Garri?
Nah, that's so far.
Now, at this point of your life, are you consuming Garri?
Yeah.
Tomorrow, you said I shouldn't ask you how to make crystal meth.
Don't ask me about that.
I said that was so, like, the finger, even the pasta finger that I used.
I'm gonna ask you that.
Cocoa powder.
We can't call it.
Yeah. I don't.
Oh, yeah. So, the question I wanted to ask you, right? So, at this stage of your life, right? Mm-hmm. As the Egbon that you are.
Ah. No, no. Not yet.
How old are you?
I'm 26.
True.
I'm not 30
either.
Yeah.
We You're age mates.
That's really good.
We age peers.
Mm-hmm.
At this stage of your life,
yeah.
Are you consuming Garri as like, oh, I have a itch, like I have a craving for it, or you're eating it like as a meal, like, oh, I'm hungry, I'm eating this thing to satisfy me?
Craving, then maybe sometimes, maybe there's like fish in the fridge. You get me?
So and you, like, you drink Garri or you smoke Garri with fish?
It depends on the flavor of the fish. Maybe I like the fish. I'm like, this thing go mad with Garri.
Because I know you're a foodie, right?
Yeah.
We've talked about this off the pod. And then plus, because when I came to your housewarming, like, the food was busting.
Tell
me
about EXO's house, baby.
Baby, EXO's house, the food. I sometimes, think, like, I think about it till now.
Do you
now.
Make it yourself? Or do you have a chef?
No, now. I have a cook.
He has multiple food.
Yeah, but there's a place for every food.
Like, he put a lot of people on that day. Anyways,
so I really want to get
the flavor of fish
like
that goes,
yes,
that supplements that white trash.
Yeah.
What is it?
Hater.
Excuse me, Jess. This is a new year. I'll not take this from you.
See, a new year, same babe. I don't know. Like, I don't know if I'm going to change.
Consistency.
I'm always on brand. What's the flavor of fish?
Well, you need plenty of pepper, like in the fish.
Okay.
Then you don't need it too soft. You know, like grilled.
Yeah, but isn't grilled fish soft?
No. It depends on how much it was on fire, on the rack for.
Okay. Can you cook?
Yes, I can.
Okay, that's why you're talking like this.
I'm not the best, but I whip. I watch. Hey.
Okay. All right, touche.
I whip.
I don't know if they're ever going to let me, like, start having food,
mm-hmm,
like that to supplement Garri because of, I guess, like the logistics of it. Like, are you about to be sitting here and be smelling like fish? Because if it was my way, I'd say we need to have beans as we do this. Like, just give me one nice bowl of jollof beans.
Beans are on that angle. It's well, a very, the problem with beans is this. When I eat, I want to eat. So if I put small beans, put maybe one or two slices of plantain. Don't ask me a question. One or two slices of plantain. Put fish. Put pomo at the back there. Yes, no.
This sounds like an order from like Mama Poots.
Yes, no. Put pomo at the back there. You get me?
Okay.
Yeah, then you know what? Okay, it's all right.
So you mix food like how you mix beets? Because that's
maybe,
a mixture.
Maybe not, but I just like variety, like textures, flavors. Like,
okay, no.
I like good food, enjoying food. Not necessarily. I always forget to eat, Sha.
Don't we all? I do you forget to eat sometimes?
Yeah.
As a creative hustler in this country,
yeah, I forget
trying to look
eat.
For daily 2K, I be forgetting to eat a lot.
I also, forget to eat a lot, but...
You know, not only do you forget to eat... So, you know how, like, in Nigeria, like, almost everybody lives in an estate?
Mm-hmm.
If your estate just happens to not be close to no food place, mm-hmm. or you don't have no food place
and
in your house...
And you don't cook, yeah.
And you're hungry, guy, you're just fast
Charles
for that
mega
day.
Chicken, man. Putting me down.
Baby! Baby. I swear down! I swear down! Because, bro, like, it's depressing. Sometimes I'll be like, bro, I just hustled the whole day. I get to
milk.
My house.
Mm-hmm. I don't it's do nothing. That.
You don't do milk?
Oh, I'm a purist. Give me that sugar, baby.
But for those of y'all that don't know, TMXO is a producer.
Yeah.
Are you a songwriter? Can we add that?
Sometimes, yeah. Sometimes yeah, I'm a songwriter. Yeah, I'm a song, producer, songwriter.
Are you a sound engineer?
I can be.
Sound engineer? Grammy nominee? He get in Nigeria for the Nigerian award shows when an artist wins... like an award for like best album.
Ice?
You the all, no, I like mine.
It's tedious.
It gives. I like lukewarm. When an artist gets an award for like an album or like a song, right?
Yes.
Does everyone that worked on the song get an award as well for Nigerian award shows?
For Nigerian awards.
Yes.
No, we don't care that much here about these things.
Which is very unfortunate because when it's outside awards now.
Yeah, because
you'll be carrying it on your head.
Because I went to check on the Grammy website, and they were like, they gave like a specific quota, like a number system that I have to meet, you know, to get like the plaque or like maybe the certificate or something.
What do you mean if you don't? Can you expand on that actually?
So basically, if you produce up to 51% of the album, you're eligible for a plaque as a music producer.
If you produce 51% of the album that's being nominated.
Yes.
So if you just did one song and an
if
like
you did one
song,
I get a certificate. I have a certificate.
Do you the like what? Do you know the reason why it's like that? Do they explain on the website?
I think it just makes sense if you produce 50. If there are 10 tracks and you produce 6, or maybe 5, then maybe touched one. That means you are practically in the studio with the artist, like.
Okay, that's okay, okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
So, you guys' album.
So, if you can tell the good people that are listening, what album or what song did you get your Grammy certificate for or nominated for?
That's a long time now.
Auntie I.
That young man in the back that's wearing spec.
Auntie I.
Go ahead.
Difference. An African giant.
Can I get a gunshot?
Bow.
I need another gunshot.
This guy is a quick fellow.
Jabu guy.
Baby, this thing is bigger than I thought it was supposed to be.
Because the ball is bigger than the last
damn.
One, so you thought well, you were going to win AJ.
You can zoom in. I'm definitely not. I don't know how I'm going to salvage this, but we'll figure it out. So, TMXO.
Yes.
Can you tell me? Should we go to the hand fact? Because if you leave me, I'm going to keep asking.
No
questions. Okay. Now, can you tell me the criteria you use to determine an artist that you decide to produce for or with?
Okay. So my criteria is different in the sense that if you use my criteria, I don't think I will beat
that's
you.
A pun.
Oh,
that's a pun.
Please, I beg.
That's a pun. That's a pun. That's a pun. That's a pun.
mad.
Go
ahead.
If you love, jot things down.
Jot things. I take things away. But yeah, my character is different because If you use my criteria, I don't got to beat you. So what I usually look at is people who, you know, I can build a relationship with.
Okay.
Outside of music. Just makes everything easier.
Okay.
But I imagine someone who's trying to make a living. I'm going to be, you know, guys gel with person before you do beats for him. But just makes it easier for me. I think I do my best work.
Okay.
When I'm able to even talk to someone outside of music. For example, when people come to my studio, studio is in my house.
Okay.
I'm always like, we always talk about everything else. Even apart from music, like, how you feeling? You know, what's happening in your life right now? Sometimes we are trying to write songs and we are coming up short. It's like, so, yeah, tell me, like, what's going on? And, you know, when you get in the mood, kind of steers you in the direction. You come up with something. You always come up with something. It's like when you ask someone for their name, like, what's your name?
Mm-hmm.
You can always know everything you want to know from there. Like, you can take the conversation from there.
Mm-hmm.
Just that bull is full.
What?
I'm intimidated. I'm listening, though. I have a sub-question now. Does that mean you don't... So, how do you sustain yourself in an industry where, like, you need to, like, people don't really take... Like, people foster superficial relationships. Like...
It can't work for me.
Okay. So how do you maneuver?
So what I did in the beginning, okay, I still do, is I have other businesses,
mm-hmm,
you know.
Mm-hmm.
I've always worked in like offices and stuff and labels and stuff. I know that my process is different.
So you don't work as frequently as maybe some of
So if everyone has like maybe 10 tracks out, now you always find like maybe two from me.
Okay.
Now I'm speaking based on self-awareness. So
mm-hmm.
It's not like I set out to say, this is what I'm going to be doing. It's just, I've gauged myself. I've gauged the situation I'm in. And I'm thinking, how best can I survive?
So as you are right now, are you a full-time producer? Or are you still a producer that has multiple businesses?
No, always have multiple businesses.
Producing was making you so much money that you didn't know what to do with, you'd still have multiple businesses.
When I make so much money from producing, I still put into other things.
Yeah.
Okay, facts. Okay, touche. Touche.
You get,
touche.
So primarily, people know me as a producer.
Okay.
I don't like sometimes I introduce myself as Timmy. Do you understand?
Yeah, it makes sense.
But I'm a music producer. I don't... There's all the pointings to show that this guy's a music producer.
Okay.
But that's the best of my work, Sha. Has always been with people that I had like relationships with.
Okay, so what's another criteria? So basically, I have to know you. I have to get... There has to be a talking exactly. stage like between us.
It's long. We can try.
I need to toast you.
No, exactly. We can try. Maybe the songs do not like click.
Okay.
But it just gets to a point where it's like anybody really, if you meet people, mm-hmm. you work on the first one, might not hit. Second one, third one, you get to know each other more. Maybe you spend a night at the club and like, damn, like, I saw this guy feeling this song.
Guy, this sounds like somebody has to court you before they get a beat. Take you out for drinks.
I can send beats now, but I've sent beats every time. It doesn't mean to turn to music.
We can stare at each other's eyes and talk about our problems.
Yes, you're making this sound very funny.
I feel like if I was a producer, I'd be the same way. But then that's why I feel like I'm not prospering, but I'm not moving as quickly as other people because like I'm trying to be like, I want to know you before I like work with you.
Hear me out, Jess. I can send 10 beats. I've sent beats to like people
mm-hmm.
and just never became anything.
Because it was just blind sending.
Yeah, it was just sending.
Okay.
Some people argue that, you know, it's not that way. That people, you know, that thing is like, it's the approach how you do your things, really.
Low-key, sounds like matchmaking.
But I've just clocked that how I succeed best
mm-hmm.
is, you know, when there's like conversation, like in between the music and...
Makes sense. How do you meet Adekun? Let's just go like that. How do you meet
him? I think Phil's did an intro. I think it was... So, fun fact, I never met Adekun Lego till... Or even I've only met Adekunle Gold one time in my life.
Wow.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah.
What?
The way I thought you guys were guys.
Yes, I just thought I was explaining to you.
Yeah, talk on the phone.
Wait, do y'all talk on the phone?
Yes, on like work and stuff. Like.
But not like, not beyond work. It's like just a positive business relationship.
Relationship works. It works the way it's supposed to work.
I don't know why I thought you and him were guys.
That's what I'm saying. The first time we ever worked was on AG Baby, and that was 2020, right? During the peak of the pandemic.
So this was Adekunle 2.0.
Yeah, it was in America. But then again, we have like mutual friends. Like it's very...
You know what we mean by Adekunle 2.0, right?
Yes, no.
Okay.
AG Baby, there's Adekunle Gold AG Baby and there's Bad Boy Dex.
Bad Boy Dex.
That's the new one.
Wait, yes, has that one been revealed?
I don't think so.
Yes, now.
Is it this cash?
Bad Boy Dex, you didn't want anybody. You don't know that. Come on, baby.
AG Baby.
Adekunle Gold is going to carry all the artist personas in this life and everyone's going to be left in the dust.
It's evolving. Like, that's... Like, even me, no, this album, if I was on this album, I would be very jealous. We make I don't lie you. Yes, now. Have you seen that rollout?
I saw the rollout. I haven't heard the album
yet. I received a package today. I was like, oh, shit.
What's inside?
Sunglasses. Like a hard drive case with like, maybe like a small type box.
Maybe one word, budget.
Yes, no.
Budget.
Good spend, like good money spend.
I think... The maddest pair of books I've ever seen from any like musician was U.S. Scooty.
Yeah.
The record player.
The vinyl player.
Sweet. I loved it so much.
Yes, sir. Proper things still.
How do you even, like, what was the process? Like, how did you get on the album?
The first album, it was, I'm trying to remember, but I'm almost positive that it was Fields that did the intro.
So is it that Fields was like, hey, Adekunle Gold, meet my guy, yes, send me your TMXO, can he be on your album? Like, I want to know how, because you can intro someone and not work. Did Fields have to like give that
I'm imagining that. So, the Sheifume was Adekunle's really good friend.
Okay.
From like young.
Okay.
It feels, you know. And like, I just knew all those guys and was like, they're like, hey, why not? This guy's dope as well. Like, you know. And I think he just, I can't remember the intro, but just gave numbers.
That light skin guy that does his videos.
Yeah. Is he? I don't know. But that's his really good friend, yeah. And I just knew those guys. And, you know, we had like a working relationship. We used to share ideas, like share tips and stuff. And I was like, yeah.
What is processing in my head is like, what made it that Fields went above and beyond to now say, not only is this my guy, but you should work with him? Because, like I said, some people can intro you and that's it. They're not...
But it's
not
his energy now. Like, it's the same energy I give Fields that he gives to me. Like, I'm not shady or anything.
So basically, you really, this whole you treating people well and people knowing you for someone that makes them feel good, I think that is something that works in your favor.
Yeah,
like, I take these things very deep. Like, I study this thing a lot.
Yeah.
Internally.
I'm not the most talented guy. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, I'm
but
not.
But you're charismatic as hell.
Well, maybe that works for me too.
No, that works for you a lot.
So at the end of the day, it's not even the music.
No, the music is there because it's like you're downplaying the music because you can be charismatic and your music is there, like you said.
Yeah, like I've done my hours, like I've put in work.
Okay, so the next fan says, our takes on the new wave of young Nigerian artists and producers. I want us to focus on producers because you're a producer, right? And this is how I want to take this conversation. So back then, I don't know how to say how many years, right? There's this blatant shift of like, producers not becoming like almost as big as artists and like having their own brands as opposed to back then. I love to see it for y'all too. Yeah. Like for real. Like it's been a long time.
I mean, there's no music without producers.
But back then, they were not giving them no respect. I'd be hearing some stories of how producers first started talking about something. Yeah, I was selling my beats 10K. No publishing.
Let me tell you something, Jess. For like 10 years, I wasn't making money off of music.
But was it because of ignorance or because of you? It wasn't your main focus or what?
It wasn't ignorance.
It was just, what then?
It wasn't making money. Like,
what if?
No, TMXO, no, explain this scene because I need to understand this thing for real.
I saw that was me building, Sha.
And it wasn't like you were there having to drink Garri every day, like as a producer.
No, I've always been good.
Okay. No.
I think I can't do that because, you know.
Fact. Privilege.
I'm taken care of.
Privilege.
Sky.
Okay, so chill. So let's say you weren't comfortable.
Yeah.
Right?
And you don't get me wrong with Jess, sorry.
You need help. I know.
Nah,
you need help.
Not like me being comfortable, like I took care of myself.
Okay, I thought you were about to say even though I have
kids. Oh, I legit thought you meant like your family.
Oh yeah, there's definitely I have family now. You've taken care of me up to this point that I can say I'm a music producer.
Okay. So let's say you didn't have family. Let's say you couldn't take care of yourself. Let's say you wasn't into like the other stuff you was into. Let's say you didn't go to school for architecture and like you could probably even get a job in that field and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say you were the producer trying to rub, you know, two pieces of bread together and put granola inside bread to eat and drink Coke.
Mm-hmm.
Like to sustain yourself. What do you think caused producers to finally be like, yo, I'm actually a brand. I'm actually valuable. I need to start putting my face out there. I need to start having different, you know, being known for certain stuff. Mm-hmm. I need to start moving like I'm high key a public figure,
mm-hmm.
almost like an artist.
Yeah.
Where do you think the shift happened or started?
The moment they realized. And what's the moment they realized? When there was an influx of like, firstly, the internet.
Okay.
When you can talk to someone who's in Los Angeles, you can talk to someone who's in London.
Okay.
You know, an influx of like label interest in Afrobeats.
Okay. Okay.
So that's when, you know, you get work from like America and they're paying you like thousands of dollars. And like,
Why am I begging this Lagos big boy to answer me when?
No. And you know, scarcity drives demand. So it's like, fuck you. Like, and I have some unknown guy in Philly that I'm making beats for that's paying me cool cash. Why am I disturbing myself with you?
So you don't think we can accredit like an era or a time period or an event in Nigeria?
Internet, no.
No, like I want a specific time, like maybe when.
I was one of the first to say, okay, I want to have my own.
Maybe we can start off with asking, maybe we can start off by stating who are some of the producers that started to take themselves seriously like a brand?
Yes, so shout out to people like SARS.
SARS, yeah. SARS is not your mates.
Nobody's mates. Nobody's
like,
mates.
That guy basically laid the blueprints for everybody, like who's doing it right now. Everything everyone is doing right now.
I found out recently that was SARS that produced. It's not Julie.
SARS was the co-producer on One Dance.
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah. Julie's.
Shank
the Shank, yeah. He was
like,
one.
Was
even that's old news. Chiki. That's old news. That's 2008.
Like, what? I didn't know what was more. I knew somebody. I didn't know what SARS had produced.
Right, 2009, yeah.
So I didn't know SARS had been in the industry that
Yes,
long.
No.
Yes. And another funny story.
You met SARS.
Yeah, we've met SARS, but like, we were in the house the day when, to record that, Good Morning, My Neighbor.
Yes, sir.
How are you doing? It's his
you
voice.
You witnessed it, W.
I was supposed to be on it, but they took my voice off. My voice wasn't voicing enough. And then it was only TMXO's voice that they used for the...
Wrote it.
For
if you need voice, I can do voice.
Got you.
No, he's definitely somebody who will come and carry soundbite and come and use it to do song group, for real.
I'm sure so. I'll give a nice...
How many points? How many publishing points will you give him?
We'll talk to the publishers, baby.
Who's your publisher?
Universal Music Publishing France.
Got you. Who are some, you know, new gen producers that you follow now? Or that you're feeling right now?
Prime.
Okay.
Big Fish.
Okay.
You know, Big Fish, Larry.
I'm not Big familiar Fish. With Big Fish.
What's his tagline? Maybe we know his tagline.
Big Fish. He's on the coolest album.
Okay.
There's a Tuzi.
Who's that?
Adi Sensima.
Oh, okay.
Sensima. Made the phone and Benzema.
Yeah.
Oh.
Does he have another commercial hit under his belt right now?
Terry Money. So that's the thing. This is what you put with producers.
No, do you know what I'm asking? No, touche. Thank you. No, show my knuckle.
That's how you put with producers. You will forget so soon.
No, chill. Thank you for calling me out. Because I don't like when people do that. The reason why I'm asking is like it's very easy
but then
to
again,
identify.
You're not exactly wrong.
No, it's not good. I don't like
you're
when
not,
people do that.
No, you're not wrong, Jess. Like, you didn't do anything wrong. It's just the way the market is. That's the game
but
we are in.
It's unfair, dog.
Yeah, it's unfair. It's well, not, life is unfair,
you're
not
as good as your last
you know
yeah,
what?
Only as good as your last hit.
Okay, continue. I'll say what I want to say then. Continue, but you should finish the list. Like, give me, like, two more.
There's a bunch of them. Original Shemzy.
Okay.
Nifkeez is killing it with Zinoliski.
Okay.
Nifkeez.
You hit four if you want to add another one. Yeah. Okay. You know why I
London.
Said...
London.
Oh, London.
That's my guy.
You know why I said that, like, what other commercial hit does he have under his belt, mm-hmm. right? So there's two things I want to say. There's two parts. Part one, I want to, like, hold on to this question. Do you feel like these people are doing the right things to brand themselves? Because you know their tags, but then you don't know them. Like, some of the names, I know the tag, mm-hmm. but then I just don't know anything past... Like, maybe on social media or, like, any other thing. That's one. Two, I had an opportunity to shortlist producers to pitch to a company that wanted to work with Nigerian producers. And like, I had to like pitch and like provide small background on the producers I was bringing. Mm-hmm. And like, it doesn't, like, you have to have key points or like points that you can make for each producer. So the people that don't live in our country, that don't live in Nigeria, to understand that. So I had to be like, okay, this producer, he's known for this song. He's known for this song, this song, this song. So that's why I was saying, like, oh, what other song has he produced? Because it might give you a deeper layer of context, or like might help you register, remember the person. That's why I asked that.
That's what I'm saying. That's the game. Like,
which is not good, because it's back to that whole label thing. Like, oh, people only care about numbers or like name and stuff like that, which is not
that's
good.
The game, baby. It's not,
can't be changed though.
So here's what I'm saying. You know, we're having a conversation before here. I was saying, like, two things can actually exist. It's not good, but that's the game.
Fine.
So that's just to play the game or free it.
Right.
Or you can change it. Like, Kanye is changing things.
Kanye is changing things in a very disruptive way.
Yeah. Anyway, of course.
The last one, I mean, we touched on this kind of in the beginning, but we can just end it out with this. So your Grammy nomination.
That's old school, though.
No, see.
Let's talk about now.
But it says through African Giant, though.
That's
2019.
That's not old now.
2021, 2022, baby.
No matter. Let's wait for my
Grammy win.
But nomination is still important, though.
I didn't believe it. I thought
they were winning. What were you doing when you heard?
I wasn't even paying. I was ignoring. Like, what did we just? I
you
swear,
would do something like that.
I'm not even kidding. Like, wasn't too. I actually went to the website.
And you saw your name.
I saw my name like the pre-release, so like for consideration, those things. I saw so,
TMXO.
Come on, baby.
but do you remember what you were doing? I love to know your stuff. Like, no, like the day
I think
you
I was
heard,
working. I still had, like, I was working at one of the labels at the time.
Working doing what?
Yeah, an R.
What labels have you worked for?
If there are two huge ones in Nigeria, I've worked for them.
I know one.
So posted. What are the labels? Because I don't know.
Wait. I worked at Chocolates in Music.
How many people have worked there? That also seems like a pipeline.
So yeah, you know what? Chop Knuckle.
Thank you.
So you know what I was telling you about, like, pipeline in music. So it really starts from, like, so the progression is like from Night House to Chocolate City.
I see.
Then you kind of like figure out your spot in music from
right,
there.
Right, right, right. So what was the second label?
Because let me
bust my head?
Yeah.
Okay.
So Legendary, their first like hit was like with Mochet, I think. That was at Night House.
What song was that?
I think
Mochet.
They had one song with
Was Mochet. There a time where both of them were living in Nigeria or just
yes, no.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Me and Mochet went to school together.
No, not like school, like
yeah, they
went as Legendary.
Yeah, they lived in Nigeria for
okay.
a bit.
Okay.
So their first like hit was with Mochada. I don't know if that's the first, but that's the one that, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Then from there, the next one was Ara with Brian at Chocolate City.
They produce it?
Yes.
Is there a tag on there?
I don't remember.
They produce that song?
Yeah.
Hey.
So I was talking about the pipeline thing we're talking about. Yeah.
Do you remember who introduced them to Chocolate City?
I don't know, but I think I've heard Mute say that. Maybe like it sends a CD or something.
Got you. Okay. Oh, back then where you could actually.
Yes, no.
Back then when they used to answer DMs.
Beat series.
Not nobody sends your papa.
Facts. What was the second label?
Universal Music.
What were you doing there?
Yeah, no.
Did people bring you on? Like, did people recommend you to these labels, or you went there and was like, yo, I want to be an A&R?
Hey, man, we heard what you can do. What's up?
Pull up.
So people referred you both
yes,
times?
Yes, no. No, first one, interesting story. Shout out to Abuchi. That's the current CEO
okay.
of Chocolate City Music.
Okay.
Abuchi was the business development head at the time.
Okay.
And was managing MI. So I used to, you know, be around the office. You know, from Unilag, I was working with Coca.
Where is he?
Coca is doing fine.
Okay.
Yeah, man. I was working with Coca, so I mean, they were trying to sign him at the time.
Yep.
So I was, you know, like, oh, I'm at the studio, pull up. Where? Chocolate City. Okay, cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, here, there. And I wasn't doing much at the time. It wasn't popping.
Okay.
I wasn't being paid for beats.
Okay.
And everything. And it was like, and, you know, I was just hanging around, you know, Abuchi. Abuchi was like, I'm looking for A&Rs. I was like, the fuck is that, bro? like, yeah, no, then me being me, I was.
Quickly Google.
And I saw a job description. I'm like, Yeah, I do this normally. Like, fuck.
Don't we all? Everyone in the industry does it in some capacity.
But I think the advantage I had was, you know,
you're a producer.
Yeah.
And you actually had
music knowledge.
Yeah. Okay.
That so makes sense. Fuck, nigga. How much you gonna pay?
So they paid you a salary?
Yes.
Do you get commission or like bonuses as an A&R?
At the time, I didn't know that much.
Okay.
But yeah, it was like, I mean, now obviously if I can do a finance fee or like a producer override or just get like points off of people's music and stuff. By the time I was like, I'm not gonna pay you that shit. I'm just gonna pay a cool bet.
So were you going, was it like a remote job where you had to go to office?
I had to go to office.
Every day?
Yeah.
I feel like as an A&R, you shouldn't have to go to office. Like, you just are in these streets looking for talent.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But then again, there are different A&R rules.
Facts.
There's A&R scouts, there's A&R admins, there's A&R coordinators, there's A&R managers, there's A&R. So, I mean, I was coordinating at the time. So, I delivered like 2 albums for MI and one mixtape for CK.
Do you... Which mixtape was it?
Who the fuck is CK?
Ooh, after the one that...
Yeah,
ooh.
After... Yeah.
Okay, so, Ayo, you still trying to play your word association before we let my good friend...
Okay, yes.
Before we go back to our house.
Come on, baby.
So, I'll give you 3 words.
Don't know.
I'm not playing, no.
You're not playing.
Just
I don't want to lose.
Don't leave me alone. Gonna win,
okay, let's do that. I'll give you...
Sorry, Sean. I was supposed to sing, Abby.
Yeah.
Come on, baby.
It's not the word.
Oh, yeah, no, well, let's go. I'll
play.
Okay, your first word. Fans.
Shout out to someone fans, me. I'm cool.
You guys,
I'm moving, bro.
I actually missed it, but don't loud it.
Jess, not to be kept to you.
Okay, go ahead.
What is Ohima?
Ohima, forget your girl. Oh my god, you know, it's so easy song.
Forget TMXO.
Come on.
Chin.
I might have a chance.
Oh, yeah, you want to
do it? No, I don't want to do chain. Give me another
chain.
No, I said that I want to. I'm gonna win.
That's a tackle, man.
Yeah,
Two song get chain.
You could have sing any two chain song and be like two chains. No, but that's not chain. That's chains.
Your niggas.
Two chains.
Okay.
See. Oh yeah, my turn. He's lost.
I'll give him very hard word. Kaku.
Sorry.
Kaku.
What does that mean? What is that? But what is kaku?
If you jam a bako, your body go.
But what is kaku? You have to give me a word I know what
kaku
it means.
Chicken. Hey, Nairobi kaku.
No, that don't count. Sorry, that's
1-8-2-7-0-6 my report of location. Only more big me. Yeah,
you definitely were
working. Mona Yuva. Mona Woya.
Anyways.
Thank you so much.
I'm getting it. Okay. Final thing before we roll out. TMXO, you gotta put us onto a song.
Molazi vaccine. Can I give one more song, please?
Ooh, that's you too, but only one will play. So you can give me another one, but you have to choose
this,
one
I'll you play. You need to hear this song. Ashake Sungba. Sungba, Sungba.
It's signed.
You can't play it, but yeah, that's my tune right now.
Them, like, can we...
Right now.
That's
the
first song.
Yeah.
I think I
like it. Ah, come on, baby. Come on. Trabaye. Baby, Trabaye.
I'm lost. I can't lie. I haven't listened to it yet.
Sumba, ooh, Sumba, la, ja, ja, ja. Ooh.
Do you dance when you go out?
Yeah, I can.
Oh, you can or you do?
That's like a money step.
That rich man two step.
No, it was a discounter for.
Honestly, I can't imagine myself going out.
Imagine me getting your babe come out. Make she did. Jess, or maybe come out now. Maybe we do on the left. Make her say, ah, this is point mouth. Fuck, you know.
Wait, but if your babe was tearing up the dance floor, would you be
baby,
mad?
No, don't do that.
Don't
why?
Do that. Why? I dance though.
Come on, grind me. Let's grind.
So you can't be doing step up dance. We didn't. Oh my, guess what's coming? Timberland, freaky.
What should I be doing?
Gang. Breathe it.
No, actually,
it's peak, good boy.
I don't like it.
Okay, okay, we out. Part over. Thank you for rocking with us.
Oh my, guess who's coming? Timberland, what? Baby, why? Why, baby, why?
Josh, dragging our skirt up.
She'll come out a week.
It's time for the circulated. It's time for the circulated.
You don't even see it. It's time for the circulated.
Just
the
corner. Give us.
Can I close out? Can I close out?
You don't like
a love, baby, this is okay. That was cute. You have just listened. Come on. Why me?
This is Jessica. Fine girl from America. I'm going to give you a fancy car. Can you see my fancy car? Come on, baby. Inside. Season 2, episode 1.
Follow us wherever you listen to podcasts. Follow us on YouTube. Follow us on Instagram. All that good stuff. And we are
out.